Hi all. Me again. Does this looks a bit wonky? I've got a new little tripod that I'm trying. Right. Count to ten. Be professional, Alan. Okay, lines. Thank you. Right. I've gone. Complete brain is gone. Oh, yeah, that's right. Right. I'm doing an introduction to what we're doing in the next project. The next project is going to be a canvas. And the inspiration behind this is that we all have old photographs of family, be sort of now, whatever, that are just laying there. And I thought, what would happen if we kind of scanned that image in and to our computers and then built a project around that? A wet media project using some digital imagery as well as some wet, which is what I'm all about now. And I'm using elements this week on this one from a wonderful artist called Hollie, and she has the Holliewood Studios, which is the main sort of contributor to the website where the other people are, and all the links below. But that's what I'm going to do in this project. I'm also got a secondary project which I will do. Going to do another intro for as soon as I finish this one, if I can get the things right. But I just thought I'd do a little catch up. What have I been doing? Right, I'd just like to show you my new best friend. Here it is. This is my new best friend. This is what I have to wear when I go outside and around the house if the leg is bad. And so I have to pop this on. If this doesn't work, Star Wars, yay! Was it Princess Leia? No. Disney will kill me. So yeah, this is what they are. It's a thing. If this doesn't work, oh, and they made it ever so easy for me that everything's numbered. That I sort of put my leg in here. Then that's number one. The bot that one. Then number two is that one. So it's top, bottom, bottom goes that one. So anyway, just thought I'd show you that's my new best friend. So, and I'd like to also show you that as you know, I like to do sewing as well. So I hold my hands up, I do sewing, I do knitting, I do crochet. And I've just finished, this is my latest cushion. It's from an old pair of jeans that I had that were very, very baggy, and they were worn when I was at a different stage of my life, that everything had to be baggy. Did you hear that? No, you didn't hear that, did you? I'll just repeat it again for the one. Everything that I wore had to be inches. So I'm going to give that away. So yeah, they were just lying. I just found them in the sort of the old suitcase. I thought, yay, I can make a bag out of this. And it's got the proverbial, it's got the pocket for the remote control, because you know who has the remote control. So that's that. So right, I'm going to put this down now, and I'm going to do the other intro to the other one, which is, and then what I'm going to do is then get started on doing it. I'm going to do a little bit on the computer as per rules, and I'm going to be using another different program this time. This one that I'm going to be using is that you can get a free download as an introduction, and they sometimes on my site a good thing, they then give out a voucher, you can go and give out a voucher that you can buy this at the program at a ridiculously low price. It's a very good program. I use it to do little bits on, and it's also, you know, you can also buy, there again, they are digitally based, but you can bring your own work in. And this program is actually very, very good for photographs, because considering it's by Serif, it's called Craft Artist, and even though it's got a, it is a package made for, I would say it's like made for scrapbooking and journaling, it has got a very, very good photographic kind of element built into it, where you can remove red eye, you can remove people from the background, You can tint, you can think, you can manipulate a little bit. It's not as big as Photoshop, but there again, see, Photoshop is like up there. I would say this one's sort of down here a little bit, but it's good. And it's a nice little pack. Anyway, I'll introduce you to it, and we will do a little bit with that. And then, what else? That's it, really. So I'm going to say bye for now, and I will catch up with you later. Okay, bye.
Hi, it's me. I'm back. Excuse me. Right, we're going to get on with this project. As I said, it's going to be a 10 by 10 canvas. And if I'm going over things again, then I am sorry. And it's going to feature a photograph. This could be a photograph of a loved one, past or, you know, or old, you know, old time, like your grandparents, your great-great-grandmother, great-great-grandfather, you know, a brother, a sister, uncle, aunt, nephew, son, daughter. The photograph can be of anything, even your pet, you know, it can be of that. And it's just that we see photographs and we get them, we put them in a journal, we put them in a scrapbook, we put them in the photo album. Why don't we make wall art out of them and celebrate them? And something a bit different. So I picked up a very, very cheap canvas frame. They came in a pack of five. I can't remember how much they were, but they were a couple of pounds. It's working out sort of, I don't know, a pound or sort of 75 cents a canvas. Anyway, I'm sorry, I've got a bit of a throat, so when I turn this round, I'll sort my throat out. But and once again, I'm going to use a program called. It's called, where has it got? Open Office. Again, this is a free program. I'm trying to get programs that will enable us to do things, and print out our goodies, and not spend a fortune. So last time we looked at Inkscape. I have been told GIMP 2's out, but I've tried it and I just can't get on with it. I'll hold my hands up. Those people that can work with GIMP, well, I applaud you. Unfortunately, I can't. It happens. Sometimes you get a program that you just cannot work with, or it just did not click up here. So OpenOffice is the one that I use for making all my letters. So not only can I do print out my letters and everything, it's very much like Word. So if you've got Word, no doubt this will be the same, and you can do the same thing. So all we're using these for is to bring our elements in so that we can then print them. If we want to then manipulate them, we then use a different program. This program is purely drag, drop, print. You know, resize and that kind of thing. We can't do anything else. I don't think with this, it's just basic. So this is for those people that just want to drag, drop, print out, then cut out, and then that's fine. So that's what I'm going to do with this one. There's nothing else to report about what's going on. Oh, there is actually. I have just finished another cushion. And I put it in the washing machine. I put it into a bag to wash it because I've used the slashing technique on this. I'll show you when I'm done because I do make cushions. And I used the slashing technique and it came out beautiful. Oh, it's fabulous. I love it. Not everybody's taste, but I love it. And then I heard this great big clang, cling, clang, cluck, clung, bang. And I didn't think anything about it. I went out, put the washing into the basket, hobbled outside, you know, one arm with the basket, one arm on the crotch, as you do. I got to the line, put the basket down, Gizzy came up, jumped into the basket as cats do, thinking, oh, nice place. I went down to pick her up and I noticed this blue bar. And I thought, well, strange this. And then as I was hanging my clothes up, on some of them there was a dotted line, dots all over them. And I thought, oh, I don't remember that. I don't remember using that stencil. Anyway, I carried on as you do, hanging up. I got home, got back into the house, and I went to load up the next lot. And lo and behold, in my hand, I had one of them plastic bars that go on the bottom, that do the tumbling. So That's where my shorts got ripped to shreds, because it got underneath that plastic bar are a series of holes. And them holes are not, should we say, they're not known for the softness. And so I thought, oh, can I slip it, you know, can I clink it back in? Nope. So it was a new washing machine. Last thing we needed to get is a new washing machine. Hey ho, comes on Sunday. Won't deliver on Saturday, but it comes on Sunday. You know, go figure. Right, I'm now going to turn this thing around and I'm going to arm it, and I'm going to show you a bit more of Holly's stuff, because this project is, we're using stuff from Holly, and she's Hollywood Studio, and she also owns Mischief Circus. So this is what we're doing. And as I say, in the four artists, I know I might be repeating myself from the other time, but from the intro, because a few days have lapsed, and you know what I think, you know, I've slept, I can't remember what I did yesterday, never mind what I did 2-3 days ago. So excuse me, hang on, I'm just going to dick and have a drink. Duck. Dick. Hello, Dick. Hi. I'm just going to duck and have a drink. Oh, I hope you didn't hear that. A big gulp. So I'm going to turn it around and show you Holly's stuff. Now, Holly's stuff is, I would say, how can I describe it, Holly? Alice in Wonderland meets Mr. Grunge. Because some of her stuff is very, 1 minute she's very soft, and the next minute she throws things at you that are, some of the stuff that I've got to show you that, for Halloween and everything, oh, it's the business. So I'm going to turn you around and let's hope I can get everything in position. So this is the computer that we're using. And then I'm just turning that round now, so I can see what we're doing. Can we see the computer there? Can I move that bit there? And of course, I'm at my widest now. I'm hoping that you will be able to see this. I must find a program where I can actually record what's going on here and talk at the same time. There must be a program out there that will help me do that. And then let's just go down a bit. Hey! Oh, that's lost. We didn't need to do that. How's that? Can everybody see? I think that's about the best we're going to get. Right. Holly. Holly's papers. You get the mix of the watercolour. I mean, if I just enlarge, can I enlarge that? Yes, because can you see? Yeah. There's some fabulous watercolours that is a start for you to then build up. And then you get the sort of Alice in Wonderland-y thingy. And then you get the darker stuff that is not, well, it's not darker, but you get your backgrounds. Isn't that beautiful? And I'd love to be just there with an umbrella, it's a little sun lounger, and then, yeah, then an army of people that bring me food. Yeah, I could be there. Stand you, yeah. And then you get these that have been created. I mean, this is what I mean about Alice in Wonderland meets Mr. Grunge. And then you've got, let's go down here a bit more, shall we? You've got your woodland there, you've got your little bit surreal build up. And you've got your dark ones that you can then build a picture up with. Okay, anyway, I mean, with some of these projects, you can cut out a figure of a member of the family and then put them in there and build a story up. But no, her papers are not like other people's. Oh, sweeties. So that's why I wanted to get four artists that compliment you and give you things that there is a nice wide range of everything. And then you've got some seascapes. And we go back one. But, no. Anyway, that's some of the papers. Then, if we go to some of the people that she does, let's have a look. Ready to use in your projects. Then you can just drag that put on the family and then just bring this down in the background. Once you get your mind into it, it is so easy. Digital is not difficult. It's only people make it difficult because they don't want you to know about it. That's all it is. Because they make it all this magical thing that you can't do and that, you know, it's impossible for you to, you know, it's only because they don't want you to know. I mean, some of these are brilliant imagery that you can build a story up with. And as I say, these are completely different to what Deb's is and Curse's is. They can differ. And then the third one, Nancy's. Well, you wait till you see Nancy's. That's completely different again. But, and then we've got the happy. What should we go? Overlays. Now, you bring things like this because don't forget, all this white is clear. You just drag it into your project and it overlays. It's that would take you, how long would that take you? Hours to do, cleaning your brushes then splattering. Could you do it like that? Could you get them tone? And don't forget, in some programs you can change this blue to a red and then there'd all be different shades of red or different shades of green or different shades of yellow. But how long would it take you to do these spits and splots? And something like this that you just drag in and put into your project. This is an overlay. An overlay means that when you put it down and you on top of it, you can, it's like tracing paper or vellum. That you've got an image on a vellum. When you put it on top of your paper, you can still see what's below, but the vellum bit's on top. But you know, it's now this is white. And believe me, white, you can do so much with the white image on the background. And even though you can't see it, is you got you. I could go on. And then you've got a little bit more building up imagery. Look, how many layers? You've got 1, 2, 3, 4 layers there that have been built up into one for you. Again, you've got some text here, you've got some lines, you've got background, you've got an illustration on that side, and you've got some text there. You just drag it into your project. You've got some text up there that's white. You've got a bit of pattern there. It just saves you so much time. And then what else? And then look, this idea here. This one here, you've actually got water coming down a waterfall. You've got illustrations. Now these are great. These I'll show you when you come to it. These are Joe and your old hole punch. That's all it is, out of a piece of paper. And yet this has all been done for you. You know, you don't have to think about it. All the only thing that you got to think about is how you can use these goodies in your project. And Holly's got so much, as I say, she does a lot more on this kind of size that you can build up, and you can put flashes of light, you know, you can put that, say if you're having a firework photo of fire didn't quite work and you needed a bit more light, just put one of these on just where the firework is and it brings it straight out. But you know, I'm sorry if I'm going too fast because I want to show you that. Obviously, this is a white picture. I can see it. It might not come out on the screen. Then what else have we got from Hollie? Let's. There's so much animals. Okay, yeah. Both, yeah, real and toys. These have all been processed and they're ready for you to use. Mammals, fish. Because it's just so. This is one of my favourite. In fact, I used this one here. I used on a card I did. I think that is. I put a cowboy hat on. It's on the website. It's on the website there. A white tiger. A unicorn. Isn't that beautiful? A puppy dog. My favourite cats, these. I love tigers. A tiger is much better in the wild and not on somebody's living room floor. Or in a dentist's office, but I shan't go there. Oh, hang on. I found that should not be there. Cut. Oh, I was going to show you. Some of Hollie stuff. I mean, you've got these, you've got crowns and everything, stones. I'm only showing you a little bit. I can't, it would be for hours if I was showing you everything. You then got furniture. Yeah, you've got trinket boxes, brushes, pots, chairs. I could talk for a long time. Now, these are some of my favourite. These are the new today. These are going to be new. I can't show you them because they're new. New, as in very new. And there's a lot in here that is new. But I want to show you these. If I start here, this is fog. And then we've got the mask. And the skull, but I hope you're not squeamish or ghoulish, but you got, I know it's very zombies, I know I shouldn't really show them because I mean, it might be a squeamish, but if you wanted to do somebody's face up as the Walking Dead, you know, you wanted to do the face, they've got all the bits here to do it, to make, you know, to make up a walking, you know, a person. You could make your partner or your best friend or your, you know, as if they would just come out of The Walking Dead and they've had all their things, but no, I shouldn't, anyway, this, I've got to be careful because some stuff is not out yet. And then you've got telephones and cameras, musical instruments, a photo lab, an old telephone, jukebox, you know, guitar, TV, phone box. There's a lot of work has gone into making these for you and for you to use. Pair of drumsticks. And then with the people, as I say, some of the people they've got here. It's not just, you've got some of the, I don't know what they call them, the skeletons in Mexico. But they're very classic, these. But it's not just them, but she also does the softer side. This is what I mean by Alice in Wonderland. That it saves you drawing. I can't draw for toffees, yet it saves you. And then you've got... Dog man. And I know you might not like clowns, but I think that's a fabulous image. And then you got marionettes. Children painting. If you wanted to put that onto, you know, onto a card that you like moving houses, and you want to say, "Come and give us a hand decorating," you got your image there. And then you've got this, again, the softer ones that have been drawn with a bit of paint. And the more, this is more your mixed media, where you cut up and you've used elements. And then you've got your cowboy. So, there's a lot here. And then for your... I've used that one recently as well. On a project. So that is some of Holly. Just please go to the website and have a look at her work. This is the photograph that is the main image for the project. So we now, what I do is that I go through all the what I want, and then I put it into a folder of images that I might like to use. Doesn't mean to say I'm going to use all of them, but they're here. And I say, because these are copies, I just delete them when I finish the project. And then there are some of the papers that I'd like to use. Let's enlarge these up a little bit, shall we? That I think would look nice. So right then, well, how do we get? And what are we going to use? Right, we're using OpenOffice. Again, it's a free download. I'm all for things that are free. Oh, and some good news. I have got permission to make a small kit of the artist's work that's going to be available for a free download. We're just selecting the imagery now, so that should be with you soon. Right, OpenOffice 4, what we're going to do is I'm going to do a drawing. Let's just bring this down and drag it across to working size. A4, format, page. Now when we're formatting pages, I want the margins to be a little bit more favourable for us. Okay, so that's the thing. Then let's open up our wrong one. That was not the one. I'm downloading some stuff in the background, so this is why it's I'm doing a copy of my hard drives. So then we just drag, drop, and then let's get that in there. And then that is more or less fitted. Okay. Right, we want to add a page. Right click, which is that one there. Right click that. New page. We're working on that one. So let's bring another one down. New page. I'm doing all this because we can then, when it comes to printing, we just hit print and everything gets printed. New page. There we go. New page. Oops, wrong one. I think that's about enough we've got for the background now. I think that's enough. Right, so let's go back up to our... Oh, it's crashed. Hmm. I might have pushed it a little bit too far. But these things happen. And I, as I say, I'd rather show you. Right, not yet recovered yet. Start recovery. Let's see what happens. Successfully recovered. Next. Well, it's not successfully recovered, but never mind. Right, okay. I think what I've done there is I went too fast and I didn't allow, because I don't know this, I'm so used to dragging and dropping at a quick rate. So let's start again. Let's start again. There we go. Right, and then let's go and drag a few little bits in that we might want. Say a clock. Now, if you want to rotate them, let's find one that we can rotate and I'll show you properly. Right, we've got a thing. Click, click again, and you get these little red, and then just using your left button, you then rotate it like that. That is the left button there. And then, so we can then just move that to there. Let's bring another one in. There. And let's bring a... Let's bring some tapes in now, shall we? And have we got anything that we can fit there? Let's have a look in our... a little bit, see if we can find something we can I don't like wasting space. Right, this is where we have to go. I think we're going to have to do the format page. Right, let's go down there like that. Let's go to 7. Okay, and then we're going to save this. Save as. Is it thinking about it? There we go. And then we go to computer. Design. And then we go to there, and then we just call it printouts. Right, okay, so then let's, we still got that space there. Let's put a ticket, and because I want to turn it around, click on it again, to there. File, save. Let's get another page, new page. Let's start off with a paper. And fit that. Right, I'm going to be extra careful with this. Because I'm doing something working in the background, I want to be very careful. So I'm now going to stop this here, and I'll then do my printouts, and then we should be over on the thing. Because you don't want to see me drag and drop. All you remember is click, drag, put it into size. Then if you want to resize it, right, left click, left on your mouse, and then just drag while you're still holding the mouse. Now, because I'm not holding control, I can do anything like this. Now up here is the undo button, so just click that. Now if I hit shift, I can drag it and it keeps it in proportion. And then I just release the shift button. So, to resize, click, and then if you're not bothered about how you want to look and you distort it, just left mouse click onto here and just drag. Like that. Then if you make a mistake, you go up here to the little arrow that says undo. And that'll take you back to your last step, and then it'll go back another one. I don't know how many this will go back. It might go back two or three. And then if we want to rotate it, we double click and we get the little red things. And all we do then is that we just press the left mouse button and rotate it like this. How much we want. I'm not holding anything. And then we put it with where we want it. And then if we want to resize it, we click on it, put a finger on the shift button, and then just drag with the left mouse button. Now, I don't want that there, so I'm going back up there to my last movement, so we'll keep that there. Okay, right then, so I'm now going to do a few more bits and pieces, print them out, and then we'll be over at the table. So, hi, bye for now.
It's me, Hans. That did dishes. Anyway, different story. Right then, we've, as you can see, we've changed the angle. Here is my frame. Let me just see if I can get this out a little bit. There we go. Here is my canvas. It's just a cheapy one. Nothing special. In fact, I don't need, it's not even, I mean, look. I mean, it's not even tight. So there's quite a dip. One thing I have, tip that I have got is that I have an old block of MDF that was just lying around. This is when I realised that this was the wrong thickness when I do my substrates. I think mine are this thick. Well, you can see the difference. If I was to hang this onto the wall, it'll pull your wall down. So, right back. I find this helps because it slips in there. Now while there's a bit of a, it's not quite flush, at least when it comes to me, you know, working on it, I haven't got that dip in the centre. Now then, let's get on to our goodies. Here is I did notice though, with the that program, I've got to hold my hands up and say it did crash a few times on me. Now, I don't know whether that is because of other programs I've got on my system, but I'm being honest, it did crash. However, when it did crash, it saved for somehow. It managed to save itself. So, let me just get this up a bit because I'm going to show you some close-up work. So when it did crash, it did manage to save the last thing that you were working on, which I found quite pleasing. Also, it layered. Can you remember I showed you that? I don't think I printed these out twice. I didn't, no. Oh, BBs. But can you remember them two bits that I showed you on how they would be layered? That program actually did layer them. And you can see what's underneath. Can you see that? You can see the map and that still. So it printed, and then again it crashed when I was printing. I had 8 pages, so I had to do each page on it by itself. But in the end, it printed. It took a bit of time, but I'm well pleased with what it did. For a free program, you can't moan. It does what, you know, it does what you want it to do. Okay, there's a few glitches now and then, but it's free. If I'd paid a lot of money for it, I would be on that phone right away. I'd be bombarding their Facebook page, everything. but it's free. And now then, let's show you what we've printed. You saw me select a few items. Here are, again, this is, this is going to be the main image. Always print it out twice, your main image. Always, always, always print it out twice, so you've got a backup if anything goes wrong with this one. If you put some paint on it or it doesn't quite work, it rips or whatever, you've always got a backup. And then these are the ones that I've taken. I'll show you them once at a time. These are some of the papers. I mean, that was done twice. That's one of the papers. I love these papers. These are brilliant, these. You cannot have enough of these old newspapers. If you can get a hold of them, you know, oh, if you find one, scan it. Oh, it's amazing for ripping and everything. It's brilliant. That's the old map. That's why I did that bit of layering, because I just wanted to add a bit of colour. Then, on the main images, some of them are done twice, because I wanted to do a few things, but I'm very pleased with what's come out. I wonder if, no, we can't spend that, can we? But I know they're just little bits, but these little bits, you just cut them out and then you place them around on your project. I mean, would you have these lying around? Would you have that photograph? You wouldn't, no. So you go, you buy some digital kits, and then they're yours. And the beauty of it is that if anything, if I accidentally crumple these up and damage them, I can go and print them out again and again and again. Whereas if you bought the kit, you've got one. You've just got the one option. And if you knacker it, that is a technical term. Knackering means to ruin. Hope you've got your pencils and papers, because there will be a test. So I could print these out again and again and again and again. Whereas, if you, like I say, you buy the kit, you only get to use them once. I mean, I'll hold my hands up, I'm as bad as the other person. I have bought kits full of, is it ephemera? If I'm wrong, don't shout at me. And while they're brilliant, I can only use them once. So you're thinking, oh, shall I? Or, what if I need it for another project next week? And then you don't use it. So here, you just print. Now, I've printed these out here because what I'm thinking, I can do flowers. I can make flowers out of these. I'll see if I haven't got a cutter that will fit, I'll cut them out by hand and make some flowers. And then I've got my washi tapes. I mean, you know how expensive washi tapes are. And you buy the one roll and you don't want to keep using the same roll. You can build up a collection of washi tapes and you can have them whatever size you want. And then these, just because I cut out the back, these are just papers that, again, washi tapes, little bits of, that's might be a bit too big, but I don't know. And then you've got number plates, you've got objects, I've got books and signs, I've got a car and a jukebox. These are all in the kit that in some of the kits that you buy, you store them, you keep them, you back them up. I would always suggest that whatever you buy, you save it onto your hard drive, and then if you can, save it onto another hard drive somewhere that you can keep separate. Here it's cost me quite a bit of money. I've bought a big hard drive that will back. Sorry, you're looking at white things, you shouldn't be. Let's look at something. You shouldn't be looking at white papers. Have a look at these while I'm busy yabbering on. So what I'm saying is that I always save your work two or three places. Yeah, it's well worth it. Just save it. And the other thing is that with a lot of this file, you will need to get a program called WinZip. I will have a look and see if I can find a freebie program somewhere that will do exactly the same, because all these files are in files that you can easily download, and they're sort of WinZip. So once again, I'll have a look, see if I can find a link and everything. Right, I'm going to stop for now. I'm going to put on the background, because you don't want to see me just, you know, paint it and put a piece of the paper down. I've done that loads of other times. So I'm going to stop it now, and then we'll come back when I've done the background. Okay, right, ta-ra for Bye. Now. Just a quick thing before I went, I thought I'd better show you what I've done. What I've done is that I've just painted the sides black, and obviously I've cleaned my brush on the, you know, on here, then it's less to take off and then you wash them. And then also what I've done is that I've taken my backgrounds, and I thought this time that what I'd do is that I would just chop them up into geometric shapes and then see how that looks on the background. So these are the background ones I've done. I've just cut them all up. I might trim that down again so I don't have two the same, because I did have two the same background, so I might chop, say, that one in half so it doesn't match that one, etc. Okay, right, I just thought I'd show you what I've been doing before I do, because when you see this, this will, it'll be all this. I just wanted to bring this, this and this together. Hope you're having a good weekend. Ta-ra!
Oh, it's me.
Hands. Just done the dishes. Right. Shall we now get started on what we're going to be doing with our thing? So, drum roll please. This is what I've done with the background. Them ones that we took out, I just cut them up into different rectangle shapes and everything. I want very oh, please, don't let it be one of them days when I've got teeth of somebody else. Geometric shapes. And I just, whoops, cut them in lines. Obviously, some needs to be thinking, but what we're doing, we're gonna. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to tone this down. Ooh. Dismiss. Two little birthday thingies going on. So I've got my gesso, white gesso, if I can open it, and I've got my baby wipes. Best crafter's, creative person's best friend. And I've got a very stiff brush, because I want to have texture. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a little bit of water to the surface. This will then help my gesso move a little bit more. And I'm just dabbing it in. I don't want to use a lot. And then I'm just going to bring it around. As you can see, it's... Don't worry about the black, because we've done the black at the sides. We can then just get another brush and touch that up. I just wanted to, it's kind of a vignette, I think is the term, when it's darker on the, well, sort of the edges are a bit more blurdy outy. And that's, again, that blurdy outy is another technical term. Right, there we go. Then, armed with our baby wipe, let's just start to move some of this around, shall we? It's drying very quickly today, this. And as you can see, I am kind of scraping it this little bit. There we go. I think I'm about happy with that. There we go. Yep. And that cleans up the sides, right? We just need a little bit down here. And just by dabbing it like this, I can get a bit of a stippled finished at the corners. As you can see, it's very much my style, this, with the corners. Now then, as I'm not going to be able to wash this very quickly, so all I'm going to do is fold my baby wipe up, spray it with water, and then wrap my brush up with it. And then put that to one side and wipe my hands on my pants. Right there. Let's have a look at the imagery. Now, this will be our main focal point. So we're now left with, what do we do with these little bits? Let's just move this to one side for a minute, shall we? And again, making sure that... Sellotape. Let's put that to one side. Right. We're now left with these bits here, what's to be used. And these are going to be... So not the focal points, but we've got our focal point. Why have I said focal point? These will be added to. Now, I definitely like this one. So, all I'm going to do is now select what images I want from my printouts and put them into a pile of what we need. So I'm not going to film this as I cut every piece. As you can see, I'm not really paying much attention to the lines. I could do, but this is not going to be a project that everything is perfect. I'm just, then what I'll do is, because this has got a rough edge, I'm gonna follow suit with the edges. There we go. So that's one down. Still got a bit there, so let's just rip that bit off. There we go. And that's one piece done. Right, I'm gonna pause this now and I'm gonna start trimming out bits that I want, and then I'll come back and we'll build up the project and hopefully finish it.
Hello,
so bye for now.
Yay!
Now then, as you can see, things have progressed a little bit. Last night, I'll explain all this in a minute. I wanted to knock all this back. So, what I did, I'll get closer a little bit, for I can't show you too much because I don't want to dislodge it, but I added a colour wash. Now, this is very easy to do. It's just some cheapy acrylic-y painting. And now you can spend a fortune on this, or you can buy some cheaper stuff, which is a glazing medium. You just mix the two together, approximately 60-40 I like to work. 60 of this, 40 of that. And then that then gives you a glaze, which, as you can see, you can still see underneath it, but it's just knocked everything back because I didn't want it to be too much in your face. Now then, you might be saying, what are all these little bits hanging around the side? Hang on, let me just get this one side. What I've done is that I've sort of built up my composition, and I know basically where everything is going to go, he says. But that goes there, like that. That goes there, like that. That's there, and then that's there. So I built up my composition, so I know with my layers on the outside what goes on, because I built it up. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to build all this up. You don't want to see me gluing pieces of paper to a board. But what I have done is that I've got my inks. I don't know if you can see that. Let me just get my distressing inks. Oops, I've got to be careful because I'll knock the ones at the bottom. And I've just taken the whites off the edges, so that when it's down, it doesn't look... Well, I mean, you can go for that white, but with the theme of this, it's sort of oldie-worldy. So I didn't want it to be white. So therefore, I've sort of knocked them back a little bit. Maybe this will show you a little bit more. Can you see how I've just taken where I've torn it? And with using one of the distress inks, I think this one was Vintage Photo. And it's just... And then I've gone, no, it wasn't. This is old paper, because old paper is very, very green. It's quite green in looking. So maybe I'll show you one of the other ones. See, this one's going in the corner, Can you see how I've just done the edges so that they're just fitted? Anyway, that's what I'm doing now. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to glue all this together. Let's go back. And then when I've done this, done all these here, I'll come back and then we're going to do build up the finishing touches. So I'm going to say bye for now and I shall see you in a minute.
Bye, back again.
As you can see, I've been very busy. I've laid down all my bits and I've also added a few little extras. This is the clock that I... well, I'll tell you what, if I show it, bring it up to you, you might see it better. Let me get that... I've actually embossed, and I've also embossed, I cut out a key. Where is it now? There we go. I've cut out a key, which again has been embossed. As I say, I want to use it, like I said, keep saying it, use everything you've got. You don't have to just buy the new item and just say, oh, I just got to use that, I can't use anything else. I want to use everything that we've got and bring everything into your creative works. So I've got another one that I did, and again this one has been embossed. It's one of the street signs. So I was thinking about here, because I know I've got something planned for there. So yeah, I think about here. As you can see, that's been embossed. And you can also notice there's a sheen to the artwork itself. That's because I gave it a complete coat of ordinary cheap PVA school glue. That's all it is. And that will then seal it and make sure that you'll then be able to wipe it down when it's dry. You'll be, because I've given it a good coat, you should be able to give it, in theory, you can give it with a slightly damp cloth, but I wouldn't. I would just use a duster. Now then, this is what I've done with our photograph. I don't know if you can see it. I've made it 3D. Now, this was originally, I took the Zyron out and I ran this through so I could get it good, because I wanted to put it on some card so it stand out and give it a bit of stiffness. Then, I love these little things, but we don't use them often enough. Can I just bring it in? Hang on. Can we? I love my little thingy bobs. That's my technical term, thingy bobs. When my mind goes blank, anything's a thingy bob. But as you can see, I don't know, because does that tell you that it's, shows you that it's like 3D a little bit. I've only used the two layers. I didn't want to go three layers in decoupage. I just wanted to give it that little bit of height. So that now needs to go into place, which will be, I've pre-taken the strips off at the back, because these ones are very, very sticky, and they are also, once they're on, it's murder cleaning your scissors afterwards, because it just, I don't know what the glue is, but it is one of the, I don't even know where I got the double-sided tape from, you know, the raising tape, whatever it is. Now, so I'm thinking about there. So, does that look level? Let me just get something to... Think, Alan, where have you put it? I had a tidy up yesterday and I have... Oh, never mind. Just have a look. Let's just get this straight. The top there. No, that looks a little bit straight. Let me remove it. Like that. There we go. Does that look? I'm looking at the camera. If I zoom out, let me have a look. It kind of looks a little bit wonky at the top.
But that could be the way that I've cut it. Oops. Spitting. These are always the hardest bits, aren't they? Deciding if it's level. Right, that is 3 3/4, and that is 3 3/4. Yeah, that's just roughly about it. There we go. Well, I can't move it now, it's finished. Then what I will give this to seal this in, I'll give it a coat of glue just to seal it. Now then, do you remember those iron finial things that I printed 6 out of so that I could make something? Well, I've made something. If I bring this up, if I bring this down, and then you can see it better. I've made the flowers out of it. And if I bring it up closer, sorry, the light is not very good at the moment. How's that? Bring it towards you, Alan. There we go. Now what I did at the back was I just went over it with my blue-grey, and then I used my flower making tools, and this is what I made. And I put another thingamabob in the middle to match. So I've just got to decide where I'm going to put these. There were 2 sorts. That was the other one. Whoops, sorry. That was the other one that we did, which this is a bit more like a, I don't know, I'm not very good on flowers, but this seems to be a bit more open. So out of them iron finials, we made some lovely flowers. So yeah, don't just think it's got to be for one thing. It doesn't have to be. We could use it for loads of other things. Right, let's get the glue out. Now I want to use a good strong glue for this, and I'm going to go thin, middle, thin. Right, okay. This one here is number one. It's not a he, I do apologise. Joe, that really gets me. I'm sorry, I'm going to go on a little rant now. People that do videos always assume that the people watching are female. It really annoys me that. You know, I like to watch a lot of videos. And it kind of really does annoy me when they just say, you know, they always refer it to the female. It would be nice for them to just to say, that's why I call everybody, you know, creative peeps. Because, I mean, we're all people and we're all creative. So, there we go. I'm using a good strong glue here because I want it to hold. And when it's on the wall, to be able to. Now, obviously, with this, you're going to have to dust it. Now, let's get that last little bit out. And plop it on there. This is a, what do they call it? When you're building up layers, it's a like a decoupage glue, but it's also a very, very strong glue. And because I've used a glue on the surface, I want it to stick. So there you go. From the digital images that we got from Hollie and her kits, I stress again, please, please, please go and have a look at the kits and everything that are available. There's something for, as I've just shown here, from a photograph, we produced this. We could go a bit more grungy if we wanted by putting more, you know, more colour onto it, but I didn't want that. I still wanted the brightness, because my theory is, the story behind this is that this person is a traveller. He travels, he takes photographs, so he goes round. He's got his boarding seats, receipts, and he's got his key and his locker, and he's got his car. And he's got time. So that's what the theory is behind, the story behind this one is that he's a traveller.
and this is what we've done to commemorate the traveller. Okay, right, thank you very much indeed. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please leave a thumbs up if you did. Any comments, again, feel free, fire them at me. I'm a big boy, so I can take both, you know, I can take the comments. So if there's anything you want to know, then yay, fire them at me again. I said that, so I've said it again. But no, thumbs up, please be nice. Go to the websites. I'll put all the links behind, down below. They're wonderful, creative people, and you will be amazed at what you can do. Right, thanks for now. Bye.